Cancer staging.
The importance of cancer staging. Cancer staging is important for individual patient prognosis and treatment decision-making, and cancer control activities. Patient prognosis and treatment decision-making. Knowing cancer stage is an important part of the interaction between patients and physicians. Cancer stage helps the doctor and the patient decide on the best treatment options and assists in the evaluation of the results of different treatments. Potential treatment options are determined by stage grouping. Although stage definitions differ by cancer type, in general, stage 1 cancers are small and localized. Stage 2 cancers are larger but still localized. Stage 3 cancers often invade the regional nodes. Stage 4 cancers have metastasized to other parts of the body. It is important to note that the treatment ultimately depends on the cancer type and extent of disease. This simplified view of staging does not hold true for all tumors. Cancer stage also gives some indication of the expected prognosis. For example, stage 1 cancers have a good prognosis, and stage 4 cancers have a poorer prognosis. But again, this depends on tumor type. This depends on factors other than just lymph node involvement and metastases. Physicians use existing guidelines to find recommended treatments and information on prognosis based on the extent of disease. Cancer stage is also important for clinical research. For instance, when patients are entered in clinical trials, this is usually based on the stage of their disease. Cancer control activities. Stage data can also be used by cancer registries to get accumulated data on whole populations. This information is often used to help with cancer control activities. Collected data includes incidence by stage. If more stage 4 cancers are diagnosed in one region, more and different resources are needed than in another region where more cancers are found at an earlier stage. Screening effectiveness. For cancers with screening programs, there should be a greater distribution of early stage cancers at diagnosis compared to before the screening program was introduced. For example, in colorectal cancer, 20% of patients have stage 4 disease at diagnosis. With a formal rectal screening program, the hope is that stage 4 cancers decline and the incidence of early stage cancers increases. Comparison of survival by stage. When comparing survival across geographic areas, comparing survival by stage is much more informative than comparing overall survival. Guideline concordance. This looks at whether treatment guidelines were used. For example, were patients with stage 3 cancer treated as per the published guidelines? For a list of helpful resources and publications on TNM staging, visit the UICC website. www.uicc.org/resources/TNM.